read it, I just thought this would be really interesting to make a film of this. I think it was partly when I read it, because we'd been trying to make a film with sort of, which was set here, it was like set here in Manchester, but we'd been borrowing a little bit from a 50s sort of noir novel. Maybe that was like as the seed, so when I read this, it was like, okay, well, actually, this would be great.
The sheriff's office handles the policing for both the city and the county. We do a pretty good job of it to our own way of thinking. We're kind of old-fashioned. Out here, you say yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am, to anything with the skirt on. Out here, if you catch a man with his pants down, you apologize, even if you have to arrest him afterwards. Out here, you're a man and a gentleman, or you aren't anything at all. And God help you if you're not.
I think Jim Thompson is a great storyteller. It's like the book, you're about page 4 or 5 in the book, he's already met Joyce Lakeland, sort of been slapped by her, slapped her back, made love to her, decided to kill her. Like, it all happens like that. And it's sort of, and the book really sort of keeps you then being surprised sort of all the way through.
What do you think you're doing with that?
Sheriff's office, ma'am.
And then afterwards, I kind of felt the book had quite a big kind of emotional kind of depth to it as well. As soon as I finished reading it, I was just like, I'd really like to have a go at making it.
Who's the girl?
Well, damn it, now that I don't think is any of your business.
Howard, you know, you're kind of a newcomer out this way, but you ought to know better than ask a man a question like that.
It's my job.
For me, it wasn't so much that there's the real bits of the film are real, other bits aren't real. It's that it's all a fiction. It's all a story being told by someone that is crazy. And I think another element of those kind of tonal kind of issues, or like what's, you know, of why people behave the way they are, is that everyone has been seen from Lou's point of view. There's another element of kind of what's odd going on in the story is that Lou doesn't know what a lot of the other people are doing. So there's an investigation going on, which he's always behind. He thinks he's very clever and it's all going very well, but actually they suspect him from the very beginning.